Here, an obvious tibial spur has now been exposed. We have finished at this point initially with the soft tissue receptors and about to introduce a burr which will remove the bony element of the tibial spur you can see in the left-hand screen. On this occasion, we're viewing anterolaterally and instrumenting anteromedially. One carefully controls the pressure of the burr on the bony tissue and also keeps the burr away from the articular cartilage. Again, we're using the camera to view horizontally across the distal tibial spur and are moving the burr lateral to medial and inferior to superior, removing the tibial spur, restoring a normal tibio-tailor angle. This is a nice oval burr which eventually produces a nice flat surface to the distal tibia. When one's operating on large tibial spurs, I find it useful to irrigate posterolaterally using the Wolf cannula. This improves fluid through flow and clearance of debris. Having resected the bulk of the anterior tibial spur now, you can see the usefulness of this oval burr to create a flat anterior surface. The snowstorm effect sometimes seen is simply bone dust thrown up by the burr. This will normally clear quite quickly. A nice smooth surface is being produced on the anterior distal tibia. The same technique is used for dorsal tailor spurs as well. The soft tissue resector has been reintroduced to clear residual soft tissue from the most inferior element now of the distal tibial plafond. Gently dusting off the area that's been worked on by the spur. As one carries out resection of the tibial spurs, one switches regularly between a soft tissue resector and an oval burr. As you'll see in the foreground, there's a small amount of the tibial spur that needs to be removed. The burr is being reintroduced now. We're viewing across the distal tibia anteriorly with the 30 degree arthroscope angled. The last remnants of the tibial spur are being resected.